Right. As you can see, Gerard, this is part of the national program which we are having as a district development fund to attend to the washaways, the roads which were destroyed by the rare heavy rains. So what we have actually done is we have got our provincial road units which are doing road construction and rehabilitation in all the 8 provinces. When we made the estimates in terms of what we require for these works, we had estimated about 4.4 million to carry out the works, but we only received $500,000, which converts to 500,000. And for Mashonaland and East in particular, it requested 250,000, and they only got a fifth, which is 50,000. So the scope of the works would require the amount which we had requested for initially. But against this background, we just have to do what is commensurate with the resources which are available. And in addition to the roads works as well, we also have boreholes in this particular province, plus or minus 2,300, which are contaminated and which require mechanical rehabilitation. But since we made the request from Treasury, we haven't received anything. But our guys are just doing routine maintenance just to ensure that the water points are functional so that at least the people have safe potable water to avoid outbreak of waterborne diseases.
And considering that we have national programs like the referendum and the national elections, are you as DDF ready, considering that roads are key to the success of those programs?
Indeed, that's the major challenge. As the fund which is responsible for the maintenance as well as the construction of these rural roads, the duty of the particular institution is to ensure that there is accessibility to polling stations. And as you can see, roads like this would hamper that particular process. This is why we are making this national outcry that let us get resourced so that at least we attend to these critical roads. It is going to be very difficult to move election material as well as ballot boxes, as well as the personnel themselves, even to carry out the exercises of voter education against the background. But anyway, we will not throw in the towel. The resources permitting, we will strive by all means to ensure that we do our work.
And the freeze in staff recruitment?
Indeed, we have also been faced by the freeze of posts. We have got a lot of skills flight which has happened in the past, and as a result, there are critical posts, the engineers, technicians, as well as those guys who do the operations of the equipment itself. They really need to be here. For example, when we move around, we have with us the director for plant and equipment, the director roads, so that at least we have a complete package in terms of assessment and monitoring of the works which we do. So the skills gaps as well are affecting us. The recapitalization of DDF should have been done yesterday. We really need both plant and equipment as well as the personnel to run the various programs. So, funds permitting, we just hope we'll be able to get a sympathetic hearing from the powers that be, so that at least DDF can actually attend to the dilapidated infrastructure which you can see. And as a result, we are here just to alert the principals as well as to monitor the works, so that at least they appreciate the crisis in which the institution is.
And one of your mandates is to provide clean and safe water. And I understand the Mashonaland East in terms of bore drillers, we are left with one when we are supposed to have close to 5. Do you think you will be in a position to provide clean and safe water?
Indeed, when we were well capacitated during those years, during the great drought of 92, we had 5 operational rigs in Mash East. The number has since been reduced to 1. Even that one is a limited runner. It is actually on breakdown right now. But we are in the process of rehabilitating it. We have got a rig rehabilitation program where we are rehabilitating the drilling rigs. And the intention is to actually have a situation where we actually respond timeously to critical water needs. The activities, insofar as the use of the drilling rig is concerned, are the actual drilling, the drilling of new boreholes, the flushing, as well as the rehabilitation of the existing ones. So indeed, that's another area, obviously, where DDF has to be capacitated, boosting of its drilling capacity. Yes. Okay.
budiriro kuno mukatisana nguruwo matambudziko amatosangana nawo takatarisana nenyaya dzemvura nedzemigwagwa.
Ya matambudziko atiri kusangana nawo kunoku tiri kuti sechibhorani chikaita dambudziko rekuti chatadza kufunctiona, tikaendana naDDF tichida assistant, tikari kundikana kuti paprovening simbi dzaidza kuti tiiti. Saka tirikupedzisira tozozoendaona nakanzuro kuti tokumbira kuti mumwe tumari tushoma shoma tobatanidza neDDF tozokwanisa kumaintaina mamboro sezviri kuita vakomana.
Ko mugwagwa?
Kumugwagwa ndo kune nhingi hombe bekuzi migwagwa yedu yese yapera, hapachisina mendenenze maroads, madrain akavharika, makavhetsi yese zvakavharika. Saka totombozotorawo community chiedza kubatsiridza, asi kuDDF tikuedza kuvakumbira kuti vatibetsere, vanenge vasina maresources.
Saka imi zviri kukuvhiringaiwo sei panyaya dzebudiriro kuti dzinatsofamba zvakanaka? Kune varimi, kune vanhu vada kuenda kuchikoro, kune vada kuenda kuzvipatara.
Ipapo ndopatiri kutochema kuti dai hurumende yaedza kutibatsira zvakanyanya, nekuti isusu vabereki vedu kuno kuvarimi vanenge vaida kutransporta zvavo. Kana road ikange yapera kudaro sezvo zvazvaita patatiri parod apa, varima vachakwanisa kuendesa mbeu dzavo kupi? Kugrain. Kwozoitawo varwere, vana nemadzimai anenge pamuviri kuti aende kuchipatara. Chipatara chedu ndichocho chimwe chete chiri mutoko senda. Saka kuti vazokwanisa kupfuura mumarodzi akadaro, so panenge pasina mukana wakanaka. Saka tichikumbira kuti dai vana DDF vadzokera chinyakare chavo vachipuwa zvakakwana, vaitibatsiridza kuti marodzi tikanga tachemawo sepaya kuti uya mutibatsire vokasika vouyawo nenguva togadzirisa dambudziko tiri pamwe chete. Ndofunga zvinobatsira.
Are you complimenting each other with the DDF in terms of maintaining roads and provision of water and the challenges that you are facing, especially the undercapitalization of DDF?
Yeah, DDF is the third road authority in Mutoko. They used to have a lot of equipment in terms of caterpillars, tractors, and you can name it. But these days they are undercapitalized and they are finding it difficult to maintain the roads or even to maintain the boreholes.
And as we go towards national programs like the referendum and elections, you are closer home, you are working with those who are planning those programs. With these roads, do you think such programs will be a success?
We would like to call upon the powers that be that they should do provide roads authorities like DDF and the local authorities with the necessary funding and also the necessary equipment so that we can then be able to maintain these roads to enable the national programs like the referendum and the elections to take place without any hitches. But in the absence of any assistance, we are going to have a lot of problems.
So far, from what you are seeing, the provision of water, how is it? And as a local authority, how are you also coming in?
As council, we also come in to maintain the boreholes and also to maintain the roads. But we are also undercapitalized, and also our funding is also limited. So we would want our sister organizations like DDF and the Ministry of Transport to come in terms of maintaining the roads, and also the DDF to assist us in maintaining the boreholes as you are seeing right now, and also to drill more boreholes.
And the absence of support from the private sector and the non-governmental organizations?
In that absence, then we would appeal to the Treasury to fund the organizations which are already on the ground to maintain the roads and also to maintain the